All right, welcome to Facebook Live today, people. It's Monday. We're having a great week around here. What a beautiful weekend. Going to have a beautiful day today and tomorrow, and then it's going to cool off a little bit, but all part of an Idaho spring, right? So good times. Today, I want to talk to you about new construction. So one of the discussions we've had over the last year is how expensive it is. And one of the factors of that is of course, market-driven. So homes are priced based on supply and demand. We've all seen demand go way up and therefore prices have gone up. But if you're talking to builders, I think you've probably also heard that their prices are going up. So I thought I would maybe share some information I read over the weekend. Is that up? We'll get it up here in just 1 second. But one of the questions that comes up is, you know, one of the discussions we seem to have quite frequently is about new construction. And in building custom homes, one of the discussions we tend to have lately is builders put out a contract that says that there's this open-ended amount. So they tell the client, here's what it's going to cost to build the home, and we've allocated or, you know, have an open-end contract that says, you know, the price could fluctuate by X percent or X amount of dollars. So most clients, of course, are frustrated by that, but I thought maybe I would try to share some information today about what lumber is doing. So if you look at if you look on the screen at the lumber price infographic that we've put up, you can see that lumber has drastically changed over the last year. Drastically changed to the point that builders have to compensate for that. It's not just a little bit of money, it's a lot of money. So when it comes to putting the framing up, the price of the lumber for the frame has gone up 3-4 times in the last year. So just an amazing amount of money. So builders can't just eat that. They have to pass that along. So one of the reasons new construction's gotten more expensive is because all the components, not just wood, have gotten more expensive. Labor's gone up. All the finished products prices have gone up. All the amenity prices have gone up. And people are just everything. I mean, we all live in the world, right? Gas is going up. So anyway, today I just wanted to share with you some information about lumber prices in particular. And we can imagine that everything's going up with the price of gas as well. So when you're looking at new construction, if you're looking at spec homes for sale, the price is the price. And of course, as we've talked about many times in this market, you have to still bid on a home. But in new construction, it's getting a little more complicated. I've actually worked with builders over the last couple of months who've talked to me about how they've lost money on homes. So they put a home under contract in October, and prices continue to go up. And by the time they get to finishing the home, 4 to 6 months later, all of a sudden they've actually spent more money than what they put the contract for. So now builders are going backwards and reevaluating how they put contracts together so they don't lose money, which of course no business is in the business of doing that for very long. But they're also finding ways to make sure that the contracts make the client responsible for all those different things. So make sure you're talking to someone who's a smart agent can help you kind of understand what the contracts mean, how to decipher them, how to work with the builders. So it's a win-win opportunity for both you guys. And it's still a great market to buy a custom home. And there's lots of beautiful new subdivisions coming around. We've done several big jobs in Riverstone, for example, done some stuff in Williamson River Ranch. So if you have questions about new subdivisions or builders or how to write a contract so that it makes sense to everybody involved, reach out to us. We'd love to help you out.